हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ग्रीटिंग ऑफ द डे। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट द LVDT। सो व्हाट इज़ LVDT? LVDT इज एक्चुअली ए लीनियर वेरिएबल डिफरेंशियल ट्रांसफॉर्मर। ओके, सो हेयर यू सी दैट दिस वन इज़ द प्राइमरी वाइंडिंग, दिस वन इज़ द सेकेंडरी वाइंडिंग ऑफ द LVDT। सो इन बिटवीन द प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी वाइंडिंग्स वी हैव ए कोर। ओके, सो the working principle of the LVDT is basically based on the mutual induction. So actually you will learn in the LVDT that how you get the voltage when the core varies. Okay, so here you see that whenever the core moves, so accordingly the voltage will develop across the secondary winding. So here you see that S1 and S2, these are the secondary windings, and we get the voltage VS1 and VS2. So VS1 is the voltage across the winding S1, and VS2 is the winding voltage drop across the winding S2. Okay, so when the core position is at the center of the secondary winding, so under this condition the output voltage induced at the secondary winding VS1 and voltage induced across the winding S2 is VS2. Okay, so both the winding voltage induced across the both the winding will be same. So that's why the output voltage V0 under this condition is zero. So whenever the core moves in the right side, that is across the winding S1, so under this condition the core will be more closer with winding S1. So under this condition the voltage induced across winding S1 will be greater than voltage induced across winding S2. So under this condition V0 is equal to VS1. So whenever the core moves in the left side, so under this condition the core will be more in contact with winding S2. Okay, so the voltage induced across winding S2 will be greater than the voltage induced across winding VS1. So under this condition the V0 is equal to minus of VS2. Okay, so here you see that this one is the experimental setup for the LVDT experiment. So here you see that this one is our LVDT kit. So in the LVDT kit you will see that this one is our displacement meter, and this one is our LVDT. Okay, so here you see that this one is our circuit arrangement. Okay, so this one is our primary winding, and this one is our output. So in order to get the waveform, that is the input waveform and the output waveform on the CRO screen, so what we do, we connect the channel 1 of the CRO to the input of the LVDT. Okay, so here you see that, and after that the channel 2, we take the wire from the channel 2 of the CRO, and after that the channel 2 will be connect to the one black probe of the CRO is connected to the input winding, and after that the red probe will be connected to the output of the CRO. So when we make the connection, so we get this waveform on the CRO screen. Okay, so here you see that when the displacement is zero, okay, so that's why the output is in straight line, you get this thing. Okay, and this one, the sinusoidal wave shows that this is our input waveform. So here you see that channel 1 having voltage 2 volt, channel 2, that is the output voltage, is 0.5 volt, and this is the frequency 2 milliseconds. Okay, so here when I increase the displacement in the positive direction, okay, so you will see that whenever we increase the displacement, okay, so here you see that whenever I increase the displacement, the amplitude of the output voltage is now increases. Okay, so we can adjust the output from this button, rotating button. Okay, so here you see that the output voltage will touch the first amplitude, the output voltage amplitude
touches the first division of this box. Okay, so in the box we have 5 division, so each division is of 0.2 volt. Okay, so in order to get the output voltage, in order to determine the output voltage, so what we do, we multiply the 0.2 and with the 0.5. so when we multiply and we get the output voltage corresponding to the displacement. Okay, and similarly, when I increase the displacement from 0.75 to something value, right, so we will get the reading again. So here you see that this one, so you see that the amplitude will touches the second division of this box. Okay, so you will find the reading by multiplying 0.4 with 0.5. so we will get the output voltage correspondingly. So similarly, you will get the reading, okay, for the output voltage with displacement. Okay, when we move that displacement, we will get the output voltage corresponding reading. Okay, so whenever we plot the graph between the displacement and output voltage, so we will get a straight line curve. Okay, so here you see that a straight line curve we get. And similarly, when we plot the graph between negative displacement and output voltage, we will get the straight line curve. So overall, we get the V-shaped curve for the LVDT. So hope you will understand this concept. Okay, so similarly, you will find the reading for the negative displacement and output voltage. Okay, so when you rotating the core in the negative side, okay, so the displacement meter will shows the negative reading. So here you see that you will get the negative reading on the displacement meter of the LVDT kit. Okay, so similarly, you will get the reading, you will get the waveform, okay, on the CRO screen. So hope you will understand the concept of LVDT. Okay, so thank you very much, have a nice day to all.